You're listening to the podcast. Dark Mode, presented by FPP Broadcasting. This week's episode is number 10. We made it, guys, to the top 10 bands of all time. It's crazy, man. I didn't think I'd get this far. I really didn't think I'd get this far, honestly. I thought this was just going to be another one of those projects that just kind of just, you know, was something, and then it just completely just like failed from like my mind and like motivation. But yeah, top 10. And now, honestly, now that I made it to the top 10, it's my own fault. I could have just started with the top 10, but I decided to go top 20 because I don't know, more content, I guess, a little bit more of a challenge. Top 30 would have been like insane to do, but top 10 coming in at number 10, it's STYX. It's STYX, guys. It's STYX. It's progressive rock. American progressive rock? Interesting choice by myself, I know. Because I really didn't grow up listening to too much STYX. Honestly, I didn't get into STYX until like later on. Like Aerosmith and Led Zeppelin and like, you know, other bands like I knew before. But then like STYX kind of came like later. And really, I didn't listen through their albums until, like, I was, like, doing this, like, top 20 list. And then I was like, oh, okay, let me just put them in here because these guys are incredible. And yes, they are cheesy. And yes, all their stuff sounds like a musical. But you know what? It's so good. It's so good. It's so crisp and, like, clean and just, like, I don't know. They go through a lot of progressions in their, I guess, like, career, their act. I don't know what you would really call it, but they go through a couple progressions in progressive rock. And it's, I don't know, I think by the end, they really, really got it. Because it was a rough start, man. Starting out in 1972. Not like a lot going on, you know. There was definitely a lot of other bands that were already like big and famous, and they come out with their very first album. Their very first song is let me check the actual time. It's 13 minutes and 14 seconds. The very first song on their very first album. Like, what? That's insane. I don't think any other progressive rock bands really start off like that hard. I mean, you know, obviously some of them do, but like, I feel like that's not always the case, you know? Especially first song being that long, like, whoa, hold on. I could see like 6, 7, 8 minutes, but 13, bro? Insane. I guess I'll just go through and rate the albums. I don't know. I feel like I like starting off with that first and then diving more into the band and like what they stand for. But yeah, man, it's top 10. I can't stop repeating that because I'm just like, wow, I actually made it. And I'm really, really looking forward to like doing the episodes that follow this. It's going to be a lot of work. And some of it, honestly, isn't even too concrete at this point. Like, maybe when you're hearing this, like, maybe it'll be, like, more concrete. But, like, right now, it's just, like, there's a couple that I could switch around. And, like, obviously, they're the top 10. So, it's, like, I consider them, like, the greatest. Like, you could really interchange a lot of these in the top 10 at any given moment. But we're talking about all time. Man, this is going to be crazy. Okay. Going into the album. Very first one, STYX, self-titled, pretty classic, not gonna lie. What did I give this one? I gave it a 9. All right, listen, it's just cause it's like raw STYX, progressive STYX, you know? And it's just like, you know, growing up, I obviously heard like the big hits, and I'll get into those, but like I've never heard any song off this album before, and it's actually really good, like progressive rock. Like, I'm not gonna lie, like it's pretty solid, you know. It's not too cheesy, you know. It's like pretty solid. Honestly, it's pretty all essential. That whole album is nice. It's like 6 songs, I think. Yeah, 6 songs, keeping it nice and short, sweet, simple. You really can't go wrong with that first album. Obviously, it didn't hit the ground running too hard. I mean, there was probably like a little bit of a following, I'm guessing, but like it doesn't look like it did like too well. Yeah, STYX 2. This album's got Lady, right? Which is like a pretty like famous STYX song. But in my personal opinion, it's honestly just like, all right. Like, obviously there's way better ones, and this is probably like the bottom of the barrel, but that's not the best song on this album. The best song is A Day. That's like, dude, that's a 10 out of 10 progressive rock song. Coming from a band that's more like, I don't want to say like poppy, but just like more mainstream progressive rock. Because they were going for like that like poppy flashiness, you know? At least that's what I feel like. I feel like they were trying to do. But yeah, man, A Day is just, dude, that's on like all of my playlists now. That song is so freaking good. Definitely check out that one if you don't check out the rest of that album. I didn't put all of it on. Actually, I think I did put it all on the Essential STYX playlist. Because it's good. It's a good album. I give it 8 out of 10. Nothing too crazy. Moving on to the next one, The Serpent is Rising. 7 out of 10. I mean, there's not really a good song on this one. It's just like a good listen through. It's a little bit rocky. I think the song on it, The Serpent is Rising, is like the best one. It's pretty good. It's just like I don't know. I feel like they didn't know what they were really doing at this point. Like you listen to STYX and then you listen to STYX 2 and you're like, all right, I think I'm getting the picture. And then you listen to this album and you're like, all right, they obviously were trying something out and it didn't really work that well. The next one, Man of Miracles. Also the same thing, man. Honestly, 6 out of 10 because it just like, if falls off even more than like The Serpent is Rising because... It just does, man. I don't even know what's like. I don't even know what was a good song. Christopher, Mr. Christopher. I think I like that one the most. And like, honestly, all of this album isn't on the Essential playlist. Only 4 songs. Golden Lark, A Song for Suzanne, Evil Eyes, and Christopher, Mr. Christopher. So yeah, check those out. If you like those, maybe check out the rest of the album. You don't have to. It's honestly pretty skippable. Next up is Equinox. I think I remember liking this one. 1975. Honestly, it was a good album. I don't really remember much from it. I wrote down an 8 out of 10. Take that as you will. Next up is Crystal Ball. How many songs did I put on this album? I think I put like all the songs on the Essential playlist because I gave it an 8.5. And that's very, very good. But honestly, there's really not like a standout like song. They have a nice Claire de Lune at the very end. I think Crystal Ball is a good song, I think. But yeah, that whole beginning era of like STYX is like a little bit like shaky. It's not so like concrete, like not so, I feel like they just didn't know what they were doing, you know? Like obviously they were like making like really good progressive rock music, but like it just does, it doesn't like break anything, you know? It's just like it's like throwaway kind of music, I feel like, you know. Yeah, in the grand scheme of things, obviously I'm ranking this like number 10 of all time, so I'm just grading it like really hard. I'm not trying to like shit talk them, but they dump John, what's his name? John Krulinski? I don't know. They dump off their third singer, and they get this guy Tommy Shaw, and like they make The Grand Illusion 1977, and it's just like, you're like, wait a minute, dude. This is when STYX like becomes like number 10 of like all time. They just like, I don't think they like destroy like the boundaries of like music or anything, but like they're so good here, man. I mean, dude, opening up with The Grand Illusion, dude, that song is so freaking good. It's in their top five songs of all time. Maybe not one, maybe not two, maybe not three, but probably four. Come Sail Away, Fooling Yourself, dude. Angry Young Man, like, dude, this album is like, it's nearly perfect, dude. 9 out of 10. Almost like a 9.5. Miss America's a little interesting. Pieces of Eight, 1978. God, another good album, man. I gave it an 8.5 just because the very first half of the album is so rough, man. Great White Hope, I'm Okay, Sing for the Day, The Message, Lords of the Ring, you can be like, yeah. But like, dude, those first like five songs are all very questionable. But the back half of this album, man, Blue Collar Man, Queen of Spades is pretty good. Renegade, Pieces of Eight is also pretty good. And then this like instrumental Aku Aku song. And like, I don't know, man, that really saves it for me. But that first half of the album, I just like, I don't know, it's like unforgivable. It's just not that good. But like the back half of the album, dude, that shit is loaded, bro. That shit is loaded. Next up, we got Cornerstone, 1979. I mean, this one's good, you know. Obviously, Babe like shines through like literally no other song has ever shined through on an album. It literally like saves this entire album, in my personal opinion. I think Why Me is pretty good. Lights is pretty good too. Boat on the River, you know, like, you know, it's still a good album. I give it like an 8.5 as well. You know, it's just not their best work, but it's not like bad by any means. Like, I don't know how to like really describe that. Next up we have it's 1979, and then 1983, Kilroy Was Here, dude, this is a good album. Domo Arigato Mr. Roboto, and then yeah, maybe like Cold War. You know, Heavy Metal Poisoning is where definitely they were definitely trying something there, man. I don't know if it really works, but you know, this album, the back half of it's pretty good too. They're really good at like finishing albums. They know how to like really like draw their albums in together. It's crazy, man. They've got like they know how to like end. Like, I bet seeing them live, dude, they had, like, perfect, like, endings, like, live. That's just a complete speculation. I have no idea. I've never seen a live STYX video. I've heard them live, though. They came to Tallahassee, and then they played at, like, this, like, amphitheater thing, and we just, like, drove up on it. We didn't, like, pay. We can, like, hear STYX. And I was like, oh, okay. I heard STYX. Obviously, that was like, that was before I had even like considered them for like a top 20. They probably would have been like 100 or like outer 100, 150 area, because like I was just like, I mean, you know, they're all right. And then after doing like this deep dive into them, I'm like, yeah, these guys are legit. They definitely were a little shaky at some points and like a little bit questionable, maybe even a little suspect, but you know what? I'd say, dude, they had a good, they had a really good run, man, honestly. And then I think, I don't actually know what happened, but it looks like they like broke up or like disbanded from like the mid 80s to like 1990. And I'm just like, dude, a band born in the 70s honestly should not be making music like in the 90s. Aerosmith was an outlier and with like making like good music. But I feel like, you know, there was like magic in like the 70s and they like found it and made music, and into like the 80s too. But like after you've used it for so long, you just kind of lose it, you know? Like, I feel like I'm getting ahead of myself, because I want to take a quick break and then I'll come back to you about like the emotions and it's not really like a story behind STYX, but it's just like the feelings, you know, that they give you, and why it's top 10 material, man.
Look at all these lyrics. Truly, I think this album is just like getting like really in the light, man. Oh. this is literally a masterpiece. Oh, I like it, give it an angelic, just like, oh.
Paradise Theater, not in good condition at all. No. Well, let's see how she sounds, huh? Yeah, that's right. Get that needle on there right there, boy. Got these 6 speakers, not this one. Oh my god. Oh god, how loud is this? Oh my god.
Tonight's the night. We'll make history, as sure as dogs can fly. And I'll take any risk to tie back the hands of time.
It's a goddamn masterpiece, man.
There seems to have been an album that I've missed. Did you catch it? Oh, if you didn't catch it, man, you're not a STYX fan. I'm sorry. At least not in my eyes. We're talking about their 10 out of 10, the only 10 out of 10 album I would give them. And not only the only 10 out of 10 album for them, but I'm talking, this album is number 10 of all time on my albums of all time list, which is secret. I'm keeping that under wraps because it definitely influences the top 10 bands of all time, the top 10 albums of all time. But I can say that this album, Paradise Theater, is number 10 of all time best albums. I'm like stumbling over my words, damn it, dude. It's like, what time is it? Oh my god, it's 4:11. Yeah, man, this album is literally like flawless. Now, honestly, like I am kind of like gassing it up, but like I'm for real, man. This shit is It's so good. It's so good, man. This is like what they, I think, were really trying to do, man. I think that they were so close to like perfection, man. And then they make this album and it's perfect. It's flawless, even, I would say. It's unbelievable. So many good bangers of a song. I mean, there's technically two songs that are iffy, but with the album itself, it makes them a 10 out of 10 song. I guess I should just like go through the album, because you really have to hear it, man, honestly. I'm like one of those guys. I'm like, just listen to it. Nah. But how many songs is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Technically 11 songs, but if you really think about it, it's only like 9 songs, because a lot of songs like go into another song. And some of them like aren't that long. And it just like flows better as just like one song, because the first song, AD 1928, goes directly into Rockin' the Paradise. And personally, Rockin' the Paradise by itself isn't that good. But when you listen to it with AD 1928, man, it's just the emotions you get from that first piano chord, the ding. And you're just like, oh, it's like if you're a Kingdom Hearts fan, you know, because like, you hear Dearly Beloved and you're just like, oh my god, like that, this is like a perfect song. That's just how I feel like when I hear this piano, you know, it's just like perfect and nice, and just like, it's just like, I don't know, some music has like an effect where like you just hear it and like your body like gets like a tingle kind of, and you're like am I listening to like like perfectionism? I don't even know what I'm trying to say here. Perfection? Am I listening to perfection? And then it goes into too much time on my hands, dude. I can't even talk because I'm getting so excited about this album, dude. This song is definitely top 5, top 3, maybe even number 1 for me. This might be my favorite like song. I mean, I know you've heard it. There's literally no way you haven't heard this song. And if you haven't, dude, I mean, go listen to it right now. I swear to God, I will find you, make you listen to this song. It's perfect. It's a perfect song. I wouldn't change a single thing about it. I would listen to it on repeat forever if I had to. Maybe a couple songs in between. But that goes into Nothing Ever Goes As Planned. And that song's really good, too. It takes, honestly, like 3 or 4 listen-throughs to really get it, and then you're like, this song is almost just as good as Too Much Time on My Hands, which is insane of me to say. But it is, man. And then that goes into The Best of Times, which brings back that piano chord from AD 1928, and you're like, oh yeah, this? And then, but it's like a totally different like song that's like flushed out from Rockin' the Paradise, you know? And it's just like, that's so perfect. Why don't more bands do this? Like, obviously because they want to make like other different songs that sound different, but like why would you do that? You don't have to do that. Like, obviously AD 1928 to Rockin' Paradise, like obviously that's not going to be like your single or like the song that people really go to. It's going to be The Best of Times, because that might be their number one best song of all time, in my opinion. But yeah, I don't know. It's just such a simple idea, and like they just execute it so perfectly. Like, it's like you listen to this album all the way through, and then you're just like, God, it's just so perfect the way it flows. But yeah, that cuts off side A, and side B, Lonely People. That's the other song where I was like, you know what? This song takes a couple listen throughs, and then you like get it, and you're like, all right, it's pretty good. There's not a bad chorus in this album. I'll say that. All the choruses are banging. They knew exactly what they were doing, man. And they executed it perfectly. I keep saying that, but it's true. It's just fucking true. I don't know. That goes into She Cares, which is a really good song, too. definitely emotional. This whole album is just like, it tears on your emotions, man, and just makes you think, and you're just like, oh my God, like, it's a concept album that's like, like, it makes you think so much, man. Based off like the 19, like, what, the roaring 20s into like the Great Depression, and then into like what, late 50s because of AD 1958, and you're just like, God, it's perfect, man. You're like, it's literally perfect. I keep just saying that. I'm so stupid. I cannot say it's number 10 of all time and not keep calling it perfect, because like, it obviously is if it's ranked that high. Next song, Snowblind, dude, amazing song. I'm pretty sure that was on the radio too, back when I would listen to the radio, obviously. But yeah, Snowblind, dude, oh, just such a good chorus, man. Like, I feel like that song never gets talked about, but I'm just like, dude, that's a, oh my God, it's so good. That goes into Halfpenny Twopenny, which is Colin's favorite song. I don't know if it's like his favorite STYX song, but I just remember playing this album for him and being him being like that. I think he said that this was his like favorite. But great finisher, man. Epic, clashing, just, oh dude, so good. And then that goes into AD 1958, flowing back into that chord, the dun, 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 dun. And it's just like, you hear that at the very end, and it sounds different too. And I think that's so, so incredibly well done, that like all three pianos during AD 1928, The Best of Times, and AD 1958, they all sound different. It's just like, it just, I don't know, it just adds to it, because like obviously the technology and the music sounds like different in those time eras. And it's like, I don't know how to describe it any more than that, but like, it's just like, it's such a simple idea, and yet it's just like, it's done so well, and so, I just keep repeating myself. But it's just true, man. Oh, it's just such a good album. There's nothing wrong with it. It's a perfect listen through, man. I'm gonna go listen to it right now. No, I'm just kidding. Oh my God, it's, dude, if I'm really being honest, this album is the main reason why this band is in the top 20 bands of all time. This album truly puts them above like every other band that I've already talked about. Because while other bands have definitely had like 10 out of 10 albums and like, you know, perfect like runs and like honestly like not really any bad songs too, it's just like, it's just different when you look at something so perfect, you know, and you're like it just doesn't compare. It's like playing Smash against like a competitive Smash player, and you're just like, I just don't compare to this guy. Like, this guy reads me, this guy fucking he knows exactly how to like counter every single thing I throw at him. He can approach me and I, you know, can't even run away. It's just like, you know, it's like that. It's like, yeah, I'm a good Smash player, and you would watch me play Smash, right? If I started like a Twitch stream. But it's just like, then you compare me to like Zero or some shit, and I'm just like, I literally can't compete. He's one of the best, man. One of the greatest of all time, you would even say. This is just another band that just goes full send. I mean, we gotta talk about Dennis DeYoung. Honestly, man. Honestly, respectfully, this guy might be like top five singers of all time. Definitely top 10, if not top 5. Even though he's not singing the entire time, man. God, this is just like, this is one of those classic things, man, where you just look at a band and you're like, I think they got like one singer. And then next thing you know, they got like three, and you're like, oh my God. You're like, what? All right, it's not really a classic thing, but it's happened to me a couple times. This being one of those bands. I mean, Dennis DeYoung, you obviously know him. He's the main high-pitched lead vocalist. I guess I'll compare him to like an album. So yeah, he does The Best of Times, basically, right? And he's just like full send, beautiful vocals, unbelievable. Then you got Tommy Shaw, man. Too Much Time on My Hands, like, dude, that guy can like lay it down. Snowblind too, like, dude, he goes ham in that song. And freaking J.Y. Young, the name I can't really pronounce because I'm like stupid as fuck. I'm so sorry. But yeah, he's like a really good like backup guy. Like not as in like backup vocals, but like because like they switch it up. Like Dennis does like I think like 4 songs off of Paradise Theater. Tommy does like 3, and Young does like looks like like 2. Like, yeah, he does, like, the least amount of songs. He's, like, a good, like, filler. And, like, obviously, but listening through this album a couple of times, you start to pick up, you're like, these are not the same vocals. But, like, first time you hear this, you're like, it could be, like, one guy, probably 2, you know? But then you're like, 3 main vocalists? You're like, whoa, like, dude, that's crazy. They're all playing instruments, too, I think. Yeah, Dennis is on keyboards, man. Oh, dude, that's honestly, dude, the best thing about this band is Dennis. I gotta be honest, man. The synth and the vocals are just like what makes this band. Like the guitar playing, who's the guitar player, dude? I don't even freaking know. I'm so stupid. I didn't do that much. Yeah. Oh, it's Tommy Shaw and Young. Dude, the vocalists sing? Dude, what the hell? What is the bass guy doing? He better do something else, man. Drummers has got his own thing, but like, dude. So that means, wait, that means Tommy Shaw was the, oh my god, dude, hold on. That, I'm just making a breakthrough looking at some STYX information right now. I should have done more research, but it's like, I'm not really trying to do research really for this. It's just like mostly both based on like opinion. Wow, that really changes it, man. It makes me give a lot of respect for those other two vocalists if they're both playing guitar. Like, god dang, that's so much talent, man. This band has so much talent, and they're not really afraid to show it at all. They're completely out there, man. I mean, they're making this music that's like, to like, I don't know. I feel like people like think they're like kind of like cheesy, or they're just like lovey-dovey, like, ballad, like, rock music. And, like, they definitely have those, like, side to them. Like, you know, Babe is just a straight, like, perfect love song. And you're like, that's not really, like, progressive, like, rock. Like, what I would consider, like, good progressive rock. Obviously, we're gonna get to that in the top 10 bands of all time. But it's just, like, they have other songs. They have, dude, Too Much Time on My Hands. That's, like, dude, that bass line, man. So good. Those vocals, dude. Too much time on my hands. Oh my, dude. Vocals and the synth, bass line. See, the guitar is really good too. But like, I don't think it's like incredible. You know what I mean? Like, he comes in with like a flashy solo and you're like, yeah, that's a really good solo. And some solos are definitely better than others. And some just feel like they're just like there because that's just like what you do in a progressive rock song. You have a solo. Like, I feel like they don't really add anything to the music. Like, not like the vocals. Like, the vocals is definitely like the main focus. As were Camel, it was more on the guitar and the synth and, you know, the music behind it. Whereas this band, it was the vocals. And that's why I feel like they won't ever make it past number 10. In fact, they might even like go down, you know, the longer I live. The older I get, like, I feel like they'll just like slowly move down to like, you know, the teens and like closer to like 20, just because like I feel like I'm really high on them now, because like this album has still like been a 10 out of 10 for me, and like, you know, top 10 of all time for like the past like 5 years that I've known it. Maybe 4, maybe not enough, 4. Definitely 4 years. 4 to 5 years I've known this album, and it's still been like ranked that high for me. It's just like, I gotta talk about this because it's unprecedented. Yeah, man, this band, if all of their albums would have been like Paradise Theater, I think they would be in contention for like the number like anywhere from 1 to 3. Because that would be like unreal. But only having 1 out of like, dude, I think it's like 10 albums. Let me check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Dude, 11. 11 albums in their run where I'm grading them. And only one's a 10 out of 10. Like, what is 10 out of, like, you know, I just keep going over this in my head, and it's really just dumb. I need to, like, keep it straight and talk about it. But it's just like, this band is inspiring, getting down to it, you know? Like, it truly is, man. You listen to The Grand Illusion, to, you know, Kilroy, and you're just like, these albums are just like, it's just like he's the STYX, the band is talking to you and just being like, yo, like, wh- like, dude, like, just do it. Like, they just look at you and they're just like, yo, why are you such an angry young man, bro? Just, you got too much time on your hands, bro. they literally are just like talking to you, just being like, yo, like, listen, like, don't compare yourself to others, bro. Like, do your own thing at your own pace. Don't give up. That's all you can really do, man. And I think they really prove that, you know. They also talk a lot about, like, how, like, time just, like, kind of comes for everything, I think. And it's just like, well, that's like the main, like, theme of, like, the Paradise Theater. It's just like, it can't last forever, man. Nothing lasts forever. Nothing ever goes as planned. But you know what? As long as you do what you do, just do it. That's not good advice. I'm not here for giving advice. This is just opinions that you aren't supposed to do anything with. It's basically just content to fill the gap of time. I don't know where I'm going with this. But yeah, man, if I could really put it down to it, why this band is in the top 10 bands of all time, coming in at number 10. Inspiring, a literal perfect masterpiece of an album, and just, like, I don't know, just good overall, like, messages. You know, just good positive music. Obviously, some of it's sad. It's lovey-dovey, too, and a little bit cheesy, but it's just, I don't know, man. I don't think I've really met anyone who, like, really doesn't like STYX. God. Such a good band, man. Incredible. I could keep talking about them forever, but I'm not gonna, because I really wanted to keep these videos, like, under 20 minutes, just because it takes up so much space, and I'm just like, oh, God. I'm already, like, over 30, and I'm just like, ugh, I guess still got to do the honorable mentions. All right, let's take a quick break.
So I've really been trying to cut out soda. It's very hard, man. You know, I've got energy drinks because, like, as a chef in these, like, high pace. You know, so I've been trying to cut out soda, you know. But I drink energy drinks because, you know, I still need to go zoom zoom and shit. But, you know, like, I've been drinking, like, juice sometimes too, you know. And, like, Linz has got protein shakes. And I'm just like, we got milk for some mac and cheese we made. And I'm just like, we got almond milk here too. But I'm just like, I just want soda, man. These Alani's just, like, don't do it, man. They just don't do it. Not even Bangs do it, man. I mean, yeah, water's definitely, like, the best choice. It's definitely, like, the best for you and shit. And I could just eat an apple to get some energy. But it's just like, you know me. If you know me, then you know that I'm a soda guy, right? I gotta have my soda. Like, if I don't have my soda, bro, like, I kind of go insane. And, like, when I go insane, I make these videos and no one watches them. Except for, like, a few people. Yo, my song's on, bro.
I turned the flash off, but you can still see it.
All right, on to honorable mentions, man. After talking about the number 10 band of all time, the 10th band, I can't even talk, bro, I don't know what I'm doing. Coming in at number 10, we have STYX. Coming in at number 55, Kansas. Yeah, man, Kansas, they got like three good songs, honestly. And like, I think Hunter said like they got like a 10 out of 10 live album, but it's like 2 hours and I'm like, man, I don't got that time. Listen to that. They have got a lot of albums too. They do, man. I think they do at least. And like, honestly, I'm not going to listen through all those albums. It's another, I'm pretty sure, American progressive rock band. And honestly, they're just not as good as STYX. Like, yeah, I'm not knocking those three songs at all, man. Those are 10 out of 10 progressive rock songs. But compared to all the other bands, I'm sorry, they're just not that good. Next up, we got Steve Miller Band coming in at number 40-ish. I think I've already given 40 to something else. I'm like not ranking these like appropriately at all. Well, they shift, you know? It's like Steve Miller Band could be closer to like 25 one day, and then next thing you know, they're like number like 60, because I, you know, have listened to them in like weeks. But yeah, just an overall good band. And I wasn't saying Kansas is a bad band. Kansas is a great band. I have a Kansas shirt. My mom got me. I love that shirt. But yeah, Steve Miller Band, just a good band. You know, they've got like five good songs, and you know, there really isn't a really bad song I haven't heard from them, but just like not really top 20 bands of all time material, you know? Obviously, I'm judging them. I haven't listened to all their shit. But, I didn't listen to, like, STYX, like, I don't know how to say this. Obviously, I didn't listen to all of STYX and then was like, oh, yeah, like, top 20 bands. Like, I knew Paradise Theater, and I knew a couple of other songs. And then I was like, all right, that's enough for me to, like, deep dive and, like, actually take a look at this band. Because there's other bands that I did that to. One of them being Tears for Fears. I listened to, I don't even remember the name of that album, but you know, the most famous album they have. I listened to that album and I was like, well, you know, if their other two albums are just as good, I might as well put them in the top 20. And for a minute there, they were like, probably like number 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. Now they're like probably like 29, maybe like 33 of all time, dude. Tears for Fears, dude. I think extremely underrated. Because obviously they have their main hits, but it's just like, dude, I've never listened to that whole album, but I did, and I was like, dude, that makes a Head Over Heels like a blazing 10 out of 10 song, dude, with that song that goes into it. Like, dude, that like threw me so hard. I was like, that is like a perfect like transition. Yeah, that's a top 10. No, I'd say that album is probably like top 30 of all time, which is damn high if you ask me. But anyways, 10cc, are they progressive? I think they are. They're not really labeled as that, I think. They're just like a weird band. They're like a, oh God, what's that band? Oh my God. They're like the Kinks, bro, where it's just like, they have a weird sense to make music, and they are very good. And honestly, they're like top like 50 material, definitely. Not incredible, but like, dude. Listen to, what's that song called? The song that was in Super Jail. That song is so freaking good. I went to a party at the local county jail. On the man's world, Rubber Bullets, dude. Oh my God, that song is perfect. I'm looking up the other songs. I'm Not in Love, everyone knows that song too. And then I think that's pretty much just that one song. They've got Dreadlock Holiday, and I'm like, honestly, have I ever heard this song? Let me listen to it. All right, I've heard that song before. It's all right. Honestly, The Things We Do for Love, I think, is probably their second best song. I think Rubber Bullets is definitely their best song. That song is a super 10 out of 10 song. That song is, I could sing that on the drive home from work and just feel so freaking good. Oh my God, my laptop's gonna die? Oh, fuck. Hold on 1 second. All right, laptop is plugged in. Yeah. That's, yeah. That's the 10 out of 10 STYX, man. Number 10 out of 10 of all time. Number STYX. Oh my god, dude. This is a good episode. I had a good time doing it. Yeah, don't worry. I'm going to tell you number 9 in a minute. I'm going to talk. This is my final closing remarks. Yeah, man, STYX is amazing. I kind of regret not seeing them when we pulled up on them in Tallahassee, man. I should have definitely, like, checked them out. Those tickets were cheap, too. I think they were, like, $40. Obviously, see, here's... Okay, I remember what I wanted to talk about. All right, so, yeah, this list is top 20 of all time. That's not saying that I think, like, right now, I think STYX is, like, the best band right now. Because, obviously, they're not. I don't even know if they're really together. They probably have, like, different members and shit, but... I'm talking, like... This is like, I'm pretty sure I've talked about this actually, but yeah, desert island music basically. Like, you get to pick like discography from like these bands, and like, that's like it. Obviously, my top 20 bands of right now list would look completely different. I gotta be honest, Strokes would probably be on there, but I think that would be the only band that would be on the top 20 bands of right now. That would also be on the top 20 bands of all time. Maybe number 9. Maybe. I'll tell you number 9 in a second. And maybe number 3 would probably be on the top 20 bands of right now. But all the other bands, dude, honestly, they've already had their time. It's sad, but you know, hey, listen, time comes for us all, bro. Honestly, that's what STYX said it best, man. Paradise is over, but you know what? It can live in our minds if we just keep the memories alive. That's what I'm saying, man. Like, it's like some Coheed and Cambria shit. Top 100. You know, it's just like, it's like outside of the music, it sounds so cheesy, and you're like, you know, I don't know about this. But then when you listen to the music, you're just like, oh. This is, like, powerful and special. All right. I'm done now. It's been going on way too long. Yeah, y'all excited for number 9? I'm excited for number 9. Number 9 is crazy. I don't know if y'all are expecting this one. It's an interesting turn, but honestly, it makes sense, and it's going to be really fun to talk about in comparison to number 11. So number 9 is Arctic Monkeys. Yeah, that's right. I fucking went there, Colin. You didn't think I was gonna fucking go there, did you? Did you, Colin?